Small platforms like ours have an important role to play in bridging the gap between science and society. For the inaugural segment of this event, we have a short message from the director of our institute, Professor Saurabh Pal, about the role of the in-house science communication platforms in the research institutes in enhancing the public engagement of the scientific community. Alongside being the director of ISRO Kolkata, Professor Saurabh Pal is a distinguished theoretical chemist. Formerly, he has served as director of National Chemical Laboratories, Pune. Professor Pal's scientific contributions have been recognized with prestigious awards like the Shanti Swarup Bhatnagar Prize in year 2000 and the SANSTRA CNR Rao Award in Chemistry and Material Sciences from CSIR in year 2014. He is an executive council member from the Federation of Asian Chemical Societies and a fellow of the National Academy of Sciences and the Indian Academy of Sciences. Professor Pal serves on the editorial boards of various international and national journals and is an active personality in the academic and scientific circles and is striving to create scientific awareness and bridge the gap between science and society.
So I am very happy that under the Cogito 137, the science communication platform of ISRO Kolkata is going to launch a YouTube channel. As I understand, that this platform is already working very actively. It is currently launched in our website for the last 1 year. The science communication, of course, is very, very important. Before I come to what the particular ISRO Kolkata group has done, I should say that the science communication has a very important role in science education, particularly in the public institutions like ours, where we are getting government funds. It is our role and duty to explain to the public what we are doing. It has twofold advantage. One is that we can explain our science to others, and that is of course very important for the institute. But even more important is that while we interact with the public, we come to know what are expected out of us, not only by the government, but by the public, by the industry, and all stakeholders. So we are here to serve the public stakeholders. I think that is very important. And obviously our science has to be communicated, and that is the reason the science communication is extremely important in all research institutions, more so in the public institutions. And I would say in all research institutions, but certainly very important for institutions like ours. As you know, Indian Institute of Science, Education and Research was established in 2006 in Kolkata with the idea that we will do frontline cutting-edge research, which is interdisciplinary, and of course impart education to the undergraduate as well as PhD postgraduate level with a very good bend of research. And I think this is what ISERS have been trying to do. So it is a truly a research university. In that sense, I think all ISERS, and of course, including ISRO Kolkata, have a responsibility that the science and the research that they're doing, how they're integrating that with the front-end education, it's our responsibility that we must communicate this to the public. I think with this form role, this particular platform has been launched. And I'm happy that this already this group has been doing very good work by writing a lot of articles on COVID virus, the effect of COVID, how to overcome the mental and physical problems in the current situation. A very special article that has been run is actually a pan-ISER women faculty group. The faculty, the women faculty is what they are working on. Their research has been nicely profiled pan-ISER, so it is not just in ISER Kolkata, but across the ISERs. I think that is very important because today it's very important to emphasize the role of women in science. And I think all of us know that the gender balance, gender neutrality is an extremely important part of scientific research. In fact, many countries have given much more importance than India, I must say, and we have to be very sensitive about this. The current situation, of course, because of the COVID-19, has in fact thrown a greater challenge for science communication, because many people, the ordinary people, normal people who are all affected, they want to know what is this virus, how much it will spread, where it will go, is the vaccine coming, is the drug coming. I think that is where we have a very big role in the science education. If we are not able to communicate, then who will communicate? In fact, I would say today the society is looking to the scientific institutions for a solution. For once, the society is very honestly looking for a solution. And I think this is a great crisis where what we are doing, how we are doing, how we are going to overcome this challenge is something that has to be communicated. And I hope this particular channel that we are launching in YouTube is going to be successful in doing this. I am very happy to know that this group is now going to launch, the science communication group here is going to launch the YouTube channel in 8 regional languages. And I think that is very important, because the communication has to be done in many cases in regional languages. And I think that's a very important part. However, when you do good science, you have to do it in English, because you have to connect to the world. But having done that, we have to connect in regional languages to the ordinary people, to explain to them, get ideas from them, and then get back to the scientific community for a solution. And I think that is a very important part. I am very happy that this is being done. At the same time, when you do this science communication, it's also important to realize that we need to emphasize on how to do proper science. The science that should be done with the proper temper, with the proper mindset, which will not create misinformation. I think that is also one of the roles of the science communication channel. I wish this channel will be very successful, and this channel, because of the popularity in YouTube, will be able to spread the communication of science all across and will be seen not just within India but all across the world. I wish the group great success, and I hope this will create a new trend of science communication in this country. Thank you very much.